Subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates.
Hello friends. There's a Chinese proverb that a crisis is an opportunity riding a dangerous wind. The Chinese perpetrated crisis in eastern Ladakh seems to have galvanized the Indian Army to seize the opportunities that this crisis is offering. A few days back, without much ado, the Army announced that one corps, one of the three mechanized forces, predominant strike corps focused on Pakistan, will be now restructured and reorganized to operate in eastern Ladakh as the second strike corps of the Army. The first strike corps, that 17th corps, will only focus on the northeast, and it will also be reorganized into integrated battle groups. One only hopes that this change is not a one-off change, but it is part of holistic reforms which are going to be undertaken by the Army through restructuring and reorganizing its elephantine size. Also, India has to come to terms with certain strategic compulsions. Firstly, nuclear weapon-armed nations do not fight full-scale wars. Thus, wars will be fought below the neutral threshold. They will be limited in time and space. So, decisive results have to be achieved very quickly. For this, we require agile forces which are more employable and which are more easily deployable. And thirdly, the compulsion is that our defense budget cannot increase any further. Our economic situation simply does not allow it. So we have to make do with the existing budget, with marginal increase for inflation in the near future. Thus, whatever reforms and changes we bring about, whatever modernizations we have to do, has to be managed in this budget. All the more important, therefore, that we must bring about structural and organizational changes to optimize the size of our armed forces. Our armed forces are largely based on Second World War organizations, which have seen incremental changes but are more tailored for the wars of the previous century. They are not suited for the kind of wars and conflict that I have talked about sometimes back. We have 14 corps and close to 40 divisions. There are 17 mountain divisions focused on Pakistan as well as China. There are 18 infantry divisions, including 4 to 6 reorganized plains infantry divisions, that is the rapids, which have an armored brigade in lieu of an infantry brigade. We have 3 armored divisions and we have 2 artillery divisions. The basic component of our fighting units is the armored regiment, or the fighting arms is the armored regiment, the infantry battalion, and the mechanized infantry battalion. These are too huge and cater for a reserve from within. Also note that we have decided in principle to switch over the divisions and the brigade size formations into integrated battle groups, which will be tailor-made for the mission and the terrain in which they are likely to operate. For this, we require resources, especially for the planes. An integrated battle group will consist of 2 to 3 armored regiments, 4 to 6 infantry battalions, and they can of course vary in size. The main challenge is how to find the resources. And then again, that there is a need for some of these integrated battle groups to operate in mountains, where also all arms composition is required, like in Ladakh and certain parts of the plateau in Sikkim. So I make a case for the size of the armored regiment, the infantry battalion, and the mechanized infantry battalion to be reduced. I propose that an armored regiment must be reduced from 45 to 31 tanks. This will ensure that out of the 70 armored regiments that we have, including the ones under raising, we are able to spare 14 tanks per regiment. That's 980 tanks. Enough for all our requirements everywhere. With we can create as many integrated battle groups as we optimally require. The second case I make is that reduce the mechanized infantry platoon by one BMP from 4 to 3. This will spare 9 ICVs or BMPs per mechanized infantry battalion. We have 50 of these. That will give us 450 ICVs. Again, enough to meet our requirements as far as the integrated battle groups are concerned. The third case I make is that the infantry battalion, which has organizationally remained unchanged since 1940 or even before that, must reduce itself down to 3 companies instead of 4. The entire world has done it, except India and Pakistan, and it's time that we also did it. The casualty figures, the induction of modern weapon systems, all support these cases. Our own battle experience supports this case. With the size of infantry battalions we have, if we include the infantry battalions, the RR, the Assam Rifles, Scouts, and para battalions, it is close to 500. If we reduce 120 men, that's the size of a company, from each of these battalions, we'll have close to 50 to 60,000 troops spare. These can be either reduced or they can be utilized to find the manpower for other more important units and formations that we are going to create in future. And coming to the last point, that the integrated battle groups, our progress is too slow. If we have to quickly adapt to wars of 21st century, then we must do it very fast. And this is the way which I have highlighted we can find the resources for the same. One additional point, and that is that exposed infantry in the plains with on the transparent battlefield has no place. It'll be shot out of the ground. So our infantry, which is the queen of battle, must not become a drudge. It must be given a wheeled APC for its protection. In future wars, it is not the elephantine mass that will make a difference. It will be an agile force equipped with high-end technology weapon systems employed at the point of decision that will make a difference. Enjoy reading the column.